What's happening, guys? Today you're back in another video with your boy creator Tobin. Yeah, okay, I'm good. My hands away from my mic. Anyway, today I am going to be recording a video of cool redstone, I guess, automatic farms. Is that what it's called? Yeah, but today I'm going to show you two automatic farms, and I was going to do command blocks, but I've done that already. So if you would like, go down into my channel's history and you'll be able to find it there. But what we're going to do is create a brand new world. And as you can see, we are in the new net. We do have the new update, creative. Doesn't matter. Flat. Show coordinates. Enter. So today we're gonna make, essentially I was planning to make an automatic sugarcane farm, automatic bamboo farm, and a general automatic farm. So now that we're here, oh man, I've got a ton of animal spawning. It doesn't matter, we're not going to be in this world for that long. Hopefully just for this video we're going to be in this world. Yeah. Okay, now this is the new update. So this slot over here is for your emotions. So when you have internet access, you are able to click this here. And, for example, it would be a wave. But I don't have access to this right now because my internet has been turned off. So, let me just go back. I forgot slime spawn in the day. I haven't played in a flat world with mobs in a while. Anyway, I am going to be starting with the farms. Okay, sorry about the pause, but I had to move my location because my sister decided to interrupt me. Anyway, as I was busy, we are going to be building the automatic normal farm first. So I think it's like this. Is it this eye? Like so. Yes, it's like this. Okay. So depending on how big your farm is. Why am I doing this right? Yeah, I think I'm doing this right. I'm not 100% sure how to do this right. The other two are pretty simple, but anyway, you gotta do this. Is how I prefer to do it, and then obviously seal off the side. And depending on how you like it, you can always add water, etc. I mean, not water, glass around it. Then you see that that's your main problem. Now, for the solution, I'm just gonna grab an. Now, the good thing about this is, let me just do this. No water flows through this. Great. So, then here, we have our farm. Oh dang, messed up. Either way, you obviously want your water to be contained. So, depending on how big your farm is, water flows 8 blocks, I know the certain. Ah, man, I messed up. It's best to do this elevated off the ground, because you need hoppers at the end, so I'm not sure how many blocks that this was. I think I was 8, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so one more. Should do it, like so. Then obviously, like you would do a mob farm. And if you don't know how to make a mob farm, I personally struggle with that. So I would recommend going over to the Easy Plays channel. He made an insane mob farm. I'm not sure exactly when. But now obviously you can make this a double chest. And you can always move your stuff around. But this is just the basis of the farm. Then we want to bring this wall up. Let me just bring the wall up quickly. You see, you can put this in the ground, but for this purpose, I want to show you guys how to do it. Ah, okay, then open up the dams. Oh, that's what I did wrong. I use normal pistons instead of sticky pistons, so let me go back and fix that. Okay, so I'm back and, oops. Okay, so I replaced the sticky piston, and then when the water flowed, I realized another problem, you see. Obviously, this is going to be now. I'm going to link them all up, make them working. then it flows into your chest like this. But now I know what you're saying doesn't actually work to keep your crop stable. Not only you don't really have to put water in between your crop layers. So if I can get some seeds real quick, seeds will just go seed forms or chest forms. Well, not really. I'm myself a potato guy. Love me some good potatoes. Oh, that pig really likes this wheat farm. He's like, I'm gonna get some good food out of this probably. But now you see the ground's already moist, so when I open this up, let me just open all. See, all the seeds will flow into the hoppers, into the chest. Bravo. And the thing is, you don't damage the land underneath. So if I close this quickly, you can see the crops are completely fine. Now obviously you're gonna want to wait for this to grow. And once it's fully grown, and for this video, let's just do this. Click here, settings. Scroll down, game settings. Oh, why's my phone so? Why is it so laggy? Okay, keep scrolling. Random tick speed up to 1,000, just for the time being. Now, what that does is allows all grass and plants essentially to grow extremely tall, extremely fast. So let me just remove the seeds, get rid of all the seeds, get rid of all the stuff in the inventory, except the hoe. There we go. And as you can now see, all my farms are perfectly grown. Now I can harvest, quick harvest. Obviously it'll be one lever. I'm going to show you how to set it up now. It's like so beautiful. Harvest is complete. Turn off the water well and your ground is perfectly moist. But since the random tick speed on my world has been amped, it's now growing a lot faster. So what I do is I take my seeds that I got from my farm now. I retill the dirt. Oh, this dirt is feisty. This dirt is pretty feisty. Now obviously you can make it small like this thing and the water just flows it down. It's perfectly fine. Ah, damn it. Anyway. You see, this ground is still one at all. It's growing too fast. Okay, so let me go fix this quickly. Okay, so what I did was, I turned my random tick speed down to about 10, or was it 100? No, I tried 100, but it's still too fast. So I turned it down to 10, so it grows a lot slower, but it works. And then you get your wheat. Bravo, beautiful. Only thing about this farm is that you gotta replant it. So now let's get into the actual redstone. Okay, so I'm back and realizing that needs to be walled up. Anyway, I'm back and now I see about the redstone. Now what I did was is I put some blocks across here so that I can do this, linking it to the pistons. Pretty simple. So of course I left this on so the water doesn't flow through. Now, obviously, if you're gonna make this like, you wanna impress your friends, extremely thing, you can always just be like, cover the entire thing up, make it look like, you can activate all this power just from one lever. But for this tutorial, I will say, we can just be a good person, and we can do this. Now, what I like to do is I put a block here, and I put that so. So, if I am to turn this on quickly, I will go break these levers so that there's still power. You see why I do it? So that there's power to it. And I broke this, so click like so. Still power, so that the water doesn't flow out. And what we can do is just flick this. Now, what it does is our water, like we showed you before. Obviously, just get the water flow going nicely, beautiful. There we go, beautiful water. Sealing back up. Now, see the ground deformed because it's not on random tick speed 1, it's on 10 or 100, I'm not even sure. But, of course, yours will be on 1 or, so your farm grows naturally normal. I just wanted to so you could see that the wheat actually grows, it actually works, the system is great. So, this is really a fairly simple farm. Flick a lever, water comes trickling down into your hoppers, so you can cover all this up, make it disappear. Make this entire thing about what I wouldn't recommend is covering here where you're gonna plant, because I've done that, So what I would recommend is you do something like this, make the steps, or even coming from that side, doesn't matter where, so you can replant your crops. Best move, rather than covering it. But now you see, as you can see, since this is a far trail, it's barely reaching. So what you can always do is place a redstone repeater. Let me just grab one of those. Competitive repeater. Give it some juice. You can set it to a delay if you want. Be like magic powers. Up. Oh. See? Doesn't really matter. Just to boost your redstone signal. Really. Oh, I broke it. Either way, it's a very effective farm. So let's move on to the next one. Okay, guys, I'm back. So what I did while I was paused, I reset the XP to 1. So because I thought, just use bone meal, it works the same. And then I turned off mob griefing and mob spawning. So I'm going to do slash kill at E because I'm tired of the mob sounds. Everything's dead. Now you see mob griefing and mob spawning wasn't turned off, it would obviously keep spawning, so it's just pointless. But now we've got a quiet world. Now you just hear my voice. My voice. Okay, and so what we're gonna need for this is redstone, an observer, a normal piston for this one. Now you don't need levers, anything, you just need the observer, redstone, piston. Then obviously your grass block. Now first one I'm gonna make is not a sugar cane, we're gonna do bamboo farm. Because it's gonna be a bit simpler. And the bamboo itself. Now stay with me. We're gonna go a bit off the trail that you think you'd need. Where are they? Minecart with a hopper in it. You would also need what else do you need? Oh, a rail to put that minecart on. Hoppers, and then finally a chest or barrel. Either one that can store the materials. So this is pretty simple, pretty easy. So I'm gonna get started on building. Okay, guys. So we are building an automatic bamboo farm, and I was loaded all the stuff in my inventory. The problem is for later. So what we meant to do? We place a barrel. So I'm gonna get rid of that space. Then we're gonna place a hopper attached to the barrel. While we're sneaking, we place a rail with a minecart and a hop on it. Now don't leave me just yet. Don't leave me. So then we wanna build up like so. We want to go back a block, come over here, come up, break all of this, this be nonsense. Okay, and then we're going to place a piston right here, an observer, an observer facing this way, a block of your choice, obviously. I'm using grass because that's all I have on me. Okay, then we have a piece of resin. So I feel like this is pretty simple. Let's just get rid of all of this. Grab some glass because we want to see our creation. Grab our bamboo. Where'd the bamboo go? Our bamboo. Oh, I forgot to connect the things. Oh, no. We need that grass back. Where's my grass? Right, okay, so what we want this to be like this. Okay, so obviously make a side of the block of your choice. You can make it as big as you want. Oh, wrong. No, get out of your bamboo. We don't want you yet. So what I'm doing is I'm encasing it so that the minecart doesn't move. Okay, and now just cover this up. And let's grab our bone meal, and this should work. Oh, come on, grow bamboo, grow. Yes, we got bamboo. So I feel like this is the simpler than this one, because it don't need that much material. And I'm sure this works with sugarcane too, but we're gonna test this out. What's it growing? What, maybe I see it from the bottom. Why ain't it growing? Ah, there we go, there it is. Now, obviously, you don't want to do this. I just want to do it this way in the process, and let's make time. Sip day. There we go. Now, obviously, you cover this up so that no bamboo escapes. but as you can see, there's some bamboo in my chest. 17. Now you see, I didn't cover it up, so if someone tells me it's actually 26. And all you need now is a couple pandas, and with the magic of editing, you'll get some. Yay, pandas! Now, obviously, pandas eat on their own, so I feel like this is more of a system for you to get. Get that away. Sorry, panda, I didn't mean to hit you. I just want to make the bamboo grow. Anyway. So it's pretty much a system for when your panda is sick, you don't want to eat by himself, he's feeling a bit sluggish. So then you can feed him. Pretty nice system, if you ask me. But now, let's build a sugarcane for him. Yes, sugarcane! Okay, so I'm sorry about all the pausing in this video, but I'm just trying to get my grounds because I'm not 100% sure on all of these. But I think I got the basics. So what we're going to do is we're going to place like this. And grab some hoppers, where the hoppers are. Hoppers. Sneak, place hoppers. Then place them flowing into that one. Run over to the other side. Place them going into this one. Okay. Then I think you do this. No. Open up the hopper. Oh, look at that. That is so cute. No. Press it against the block. Yes. Press them against this block too. It flows in. And then obviously I was not very smart. And I forgot to block this off. So that's what you want. And then you want to cover this up like this. I'm not 100% sure on this one. I'm not sure how it works. But I don't think this is going to be like this, so. Oops. Off, dry it up. So I feel like it's going to be like that, so that's your chest. Now comes the redstone part. Now, as you saw in the last one, it wasn't that complicated, so I'm going to try that system on here. So then we're just going to go up about two blocks. Oh, no, on top of the bamboo. Bamboo. So we can get rid of these, get rid of this, this, and this, and I think that I am not the best at farming. I like my old school farm, but I mean, if this is what helps people be more, efficient, I mean, I'm all for it. It's good to be efficient. And then obviously, we're going to turn these around. So you see, it's pretty much the same as the bamboo farm. It's exactly the same, it's just bigger. So then I think that's how you do it, I'm not 100% sure. And then let's just grab these. Oh man, dump the glass. Oh, I'm gonna go grab some glass. And then obviously grab some bone meal, yes. Now just cover this baby up in glass. Okay, so I placed all the glass, and the pandas are walking everywhere. So, this is three simple forms, but we have to test this one. Click. Oh, it works. Only problem with it, since all the rest is connected, but I guess since we plant them all at the same time, they'll grow all at the same time. Let's spam the ground. Yes, grow, my pretties. Grow, flatlands. Yes. Yeah, okay, I'm over it. Anyway, so you see, if I do this, you can gain a lot of bone meal. Anyway, I'm gonna end the video here. Thanks for watching. Creator Turban out. Peace.